What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode. I'm your host, T. Welcome to the Adventures of TNT. Now, today we have a special request. This is coming from our patron, Dork Knight, which he has sponsored this video in which we're checking out the Sex Pistols. And the song is called God Save the Queen. Now, guys, if you've been following me on this journey, right now I've been going back exploring some early punk rock, in which I believe the last early band I did was Ramones, the Ramones. And unfortunately, the video was blocked on YouTube, and so it never made it up. Something funny happened. The video was blocked, but then it got views. And so I'm not sure if the record company seen the video that I made and they decided to release it and made it public. But all I know is when I originally uploaded it, it was blocked, and I had to put it on my Patreon so that my patrons can watch it. Hopefully, this video doesn't get blocked, and we'll be able to check it out together. So if you see this video, then it made it. If not, then you guys are probably watching it on Patreon. Anyway, this genre of music really fascinates me because I'm really enjoying punk rock. I'm really enjoying the journey of the sound and the style, but I really like what I'm seeing as far as the roots, because when I watch videos like Ramones and I look at their style and how they were dressing, I see how that whole style like influenced all of metal, with the tight spiky collars and tight leather jackets and everything, and even the skinny jeans. A lot of metalheads and rockers, they end up adopting that into their own styles. And so when I watch older videos like that, I'm like, wow, this is really cool, especially with the lyrics. You know, punk rock has always been known to not hold their tongue when it comes to having what's on their mind. And so when you watch these early punk rock bands and you see how they were doing it and what they were talking about at the times, it's very interesting, especially when you find that some of the things that they were saying are still relevant today. But anyway, let's go ahead and jump into this song. Once again, this is God Save the Queen by Sex Pistols. Let's go. And I believe this came out in 77. God save the Queen, the fascist regime. It made you a moron, potential hate bomb. God save the Queen, she ain't no human being. Yikes. Oh, man. Jesus. Oh man, that is crazy. Wow. All right, so this is really cool. It's very interesting because when I watch this video and I listen to the sound, as simple and generic as it sounds, like I said, this came out in 77. So this was before all the other bands that I ended up hearing in the 90s, which sound exactly like this. Even now, come what, 40 years later, the newer bands that are coming out have this same kind of punk sound. So this, in a way, this is the root and the foundation of alternative punk and pop punk, because a lot of pop punk bands, they kind of use this kind of sound. But this falls in line with the expectations of what I've grown to love about punk rock music. These guys were talking about something that was very important to them at the time. And I'm surprised that they were even able to make this song. I want to know if this even was allowed to be played on the radio in the UK, because something like this, it's like, it's almost like you would get in trouble for playing something like this, you know? And so there was a couple of verses in here that kind of stood out to me. I was trying to watch the video, but then I'm trying to read the lyrics as well. And so I didn't catch everything. But to me, this seems like it's a play on society and how everyone has been brainwashed to worship the royal family and the queen. And so I don't know too much about the British royal family, but because my wife, she does a lot of research on that kind of stuff, and from what she told me was that there were a lot of bad things that they did in the past, and a lot of people overlook that just because they're royals. And so they're, you know, with words like "God save the Queen," she ain't no human being, and there's no future. Or what did it say? It said tourists are money, but our figurehead is not what she seems. And so they, for some reason, it's like society or the establishment, they uphold the royal family, or they uphold the figurehead, the queen, because people come to the UK for that. They come to see Buckingham Palace, and they come to see everything because it's like royalty and everything. And yeah, these guys are like, yo, that's not what it seems. But hey, you know, you guys have been brainwashed. You're just being sheep. You're gonna follow what they say and not really look into things. And yeah, fine, whatever. God save the queen. Because without the queen, there's no future. And they keep saying that, like, with there's no future without the royal family, or without this and that, there's no future. And so, very, very interesting. It makes me actually want to look more into the lyrics of this, and try to grasp a little bit more understanding of what they meant behind this song. As I said, this was a first time listen, and so I'm probably going to listen to it again without the video, because the video was kind of distracting. But at the same time, I did like watching the style, because like I said, you know, in the early eras of punk rock music, like these musicians, these guys, they dressed different because everybody wanted to stand out. So yeah, so I do want to hear some more music from Sex Pistols. So of course, guys, if you have any suggestions, go ahead and leave them down below in the comment section. As always, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time. Peace.